some tips for installation. Of course, you want the glass to be clean. This has been detailed. I'm using the center line of the sticker to match with the center of my emblem, so I can try and get it straight. You want it to be level. Of course, if it's crooked, it won't be as effective. Now, if you have a sedan with a slanted, your window is slanted like that, you may want to consider putting it on the trunk, if your trunk is big enough. Or another way, because if the sticker is slanted, it won't be seen from the rear as well. Luckily, this is a hatchback, which is basically straight up and down. And I'm just slowly doing this. I'm gonna slowly go across to try and make sure that I get it straight. Now, as you can see here, I'm actually gonna use the defroster line. You can see it right behind the sticker. See the defroster line? I'm gonna use that as my guide to make sure that it's on straight. And you'll see here there's a wrinkle. There's gonna be three wrinkles from the shipping where it's folded. So you want to make sure and use your finger to slowly go across and iron out the wrinkles so it goes on flat. So it's all done. Looks relatively straight. It has a curve because of the window. You see, I used the defroster line to make that level, and the defroster line here as my end point, and it matches up here. So it should look pretty good. There are some other ways you could do this. If you don't like the sticker on the window, you could probably stick it here if there was room on your car, or on the side, but it would be less effective. You would have to have two of these, one on each side. You could also tape or stick this to a magnet and put them on anywhere on the car, bumper sticker even. It all would work the same, but we'll start with this, see how it goes. Let me show you how it looks on the inside. So here's the inside of the sticker. From the driver view, actually, you can barely see it, so it doesn't affect your drivability at all, which is good.